Investigating the cause of today's natural gas explosion in Millersville, Lancaster County. It's our top story in the first 11 at 11. Miraculously, no one was hurt in today's explosion, but the incident caused extensive damage and shut down a major Millersville intersection. My co-anchor Janelle Stelson's live at George and Manor Streets tonight with the latest. Good evening, Janelle.
Good evening, Ron. This all started around 11:45 this morning here in Millersville, and I might say it's on the main road in and out of town, causing even more problems. A private contractor was installing fiber optic cable for Millersville for AT&T when they apparently ruptured the pipe. Now, while we were on the scene interviewing the fire commissioner about that, an explosion blew apart a house on Manor Street. Tonight, UGI crews drilled a hole in Manor Street to get to the damaged pipe to learn exactly what caused the accident. And look at the damage. The rupture started in the basement and blew out the front wall and part of the side. Tonight, the couple that lived here, including the fire chief's son, they were trying to salvage whatever belongings they could before a demolition team moves in and brings the rest of the building down, as it is very obviously structurally unsound. The good news, nobody was hurt. In fact, fire crews went in and rescued the couple's dog, Maddie, right before the explosion. You can see them tonight getting Maddie's crate out of what used to be their home. Back here live, there is more good news tonight. Joining us is Fire Commissioner Dwayne Hagelgans. Once again, thank you for being here. It's been a long day.
It's been a very long day at this point.
It has. The good news happened right about 9 o'clock for, I guess, people within a several-mile radius of this area.
Correct. The PB&O was able to put the power and the grid back on so that people could return to their homes and they had power for heat, et cetera, this evening.
UGI, to do that, had to go door-to-door and keep taking monitoring readings in basements and making sure that everybody, the levels were low enough to get the lights back on.
That's correct. There was a concern, and there were a lot of properties that had gas in the basement, so they did not want to turn the electric back on. Obviously, another spark could have caused another explosion.
Yeah. I just talked to the lead UGI man on the scene as well. He tells me that around, you can see them working behind us, around 1:30, 2 o'clock this morning, they believe they'll have this line repaired, and then they're going to start going door-to-door again to try to get service back on to the folks who have natural gas service here.
Yeah, that's correct, because what has to happen is they have to individually go on and turn each meter on to make sure that the pilot lights are on so that they don't have other gas leaks in the property, so it has to be an individual property basis.
That's the good news. The bad news, let's talk a little bit about traffic tomorrow morning. I think you said earlier 4,000, 5,000 cars. We are on the main thoroughfare, as I said, in and out of Millersville and Millersville University, obviously, concerned tomorrow morning.
Yeah, the main thoroughfare here, Manor Avenue, will be closed tomorrow throughout the course of the day because the property that exploded will be brought down tomorrow. So people coming in Blue Rock Road will have to go out and detour on Prince Street over to Cottage or Frederick. People coming in off of 741 will only be able to go to Her Avenue, and they'll have to detour over to Cottage Avenue also. Extra police will be in the borough trying to direct traffic, trying to make it a little bit easier. But this main thoroughfare will be closed all day tomorrow.
And you think demolition is going to take about 6 or 7 hours, so maybe by afternoon rush, evening rush, you could be finished.
Hopefully, if everything goes well by evening rush, we should have the main thoroughfare back open.
All right. Been a very long night, and I suspect we're going to want to talk to you tomorrow morning for an update to see how things are going. So get some rest, and we thank you very much.
Right.
Dwayne Hagelgans, the fire commissioner, for being
thank
here.
Thank you.
All right. Take care. So that's the situation. It's going to be a rough rush hour in Millersville tomorrow, but the good news is the folks around here in a several-mile radius did get their power on at 9 tonight, and the about a dozen or so UGI customers should get service back later this morning, I guess overnight, I should say, around 3 in the morning when the crews start going door-to-door. Back to you, Ron.
What a long day it's been there in Millersville. All right.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Janelle.